yes, 3 videos in one day. I'm putting these up for you guys. Hopefully you get all these in one day. All of these videos, me wearing this shirt, they were all recorded on Wednesday, April 20th, okay? So I hope that you guys get, depends on when I edit. But anyway, you can see what the title of this video is. It is time for a gospel stew of reviews, people. Yes, there's been a lot going on in the gospel edition. In the gospel world, I have my notes, so I'm going to apologize now because I have to read off of my notes in order to get everything into it. So let's start this episode of Gospel Stew of Reviews. Can I get an intro? Public service announcement. Mind if I talk to you right quick, homie? Just that real talk, you know what I mean? Let's go. Now let me blow your high. I give you truth over beats while you twisting that lie. Okay, guys, so let's start off this edition of Gospel Stew of Reviews, giving you a little bit of news in the gospel scene today, April 20th, down in Atlanta at the Fox Theater. Your girl, Sherry Shepherd, is hosting the 42nd Annual Dove Awards. The people are already on Twitter that are tweeting out the winners and whatnot. I ain't gonna be on Twitter because I don't want to know who wins. I actually want to watch the show. I haven't watched the Dove Awards before. Now, if you don't know what the Dove Awards are, this is kind of like the Grammys. But the businessman a thug, homie, this the outcome. Death, separation, condemnation by he who was just sent to judge the whole nation. Being the host for this year, okay? Let's keep it moving, people. I want to send out shout-outs and congratulations. First, I gotta say this to Miss Kim Burrell. I was supposed to do this Gospel Stew Reviews way back in February, okay? But back in February, the beginning of the month, Kim Burrell was installed as the pastor of the Love and Liberty Fellowship Church in Houston, Texas. So she is taking over pastoral duties over there. That had me wondering because I was like, wait a minute, she was supposed to be shooting a reality show. And what about this inspirational secular album that she was supposed to be coming out with? Is this going to be put on the back burner? Although she is concentrating on her pastoral duties, we did see her come back with Whitney Houston at the Celebration of Gospel, but she is also going to be releasing an album. It's called the Love Album, okay? I'm gonna give it a shot because, you know, my album with Kim Burrell, I mean, not my album, but my video that I did, like, last year, because Alcohol Harmony sent out a tweet about Kim Burrell leaving gospel, and it got my ears to percolating, and I'm like, ooh, 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 let me go find out what's going on. So I did a quick little video about Kim Burrell. I didn't state whether or not I was for or against. I just gave out some questions, and people are still, you know, commenting on that video. You haven't seen that video, look at the closet door and click on that link and look at the video. You know, I just said a little something, something. I was just asking questions. Dang. Hey guys, also congratulations go out to Bishop Hezekiah Walker. Now I have to read this one. He is going to be installed as the new presiding prelate of the Pentecostal Churches of Jesus Christ. I don't know what that means, but I do know that it's like a really, really high position within the Pentecostal Churches of Jesus Christ. Bishop Kenneth Morales, I think that's how you say his name, Morales Sr., was the last to hold that position, and he passed away last year in September. So now Bishop Hezekiah Walker is going to be installed into the position. It's going to take place in June. There's going to be like a big old concert, a big old service for him that's going to be happening. It's going to be in Bridgeport, Connecticut. So if you're in the area, go check it out, okay? He's the hip-hop pastor. I'm pretty sure Pete Diddy's going to be there, okay? Go ahead and check that out. Let's keep it moving. So Sunday's Best Season 4. Lil Birdie told me that it was going to be premiering April 17th. I ain't heard nothing about it. April 17th, I'm looking at 8 o'clock. April 17th, I'm on BET looking like what? I don't see no Sunday's Best. Now, they did do the auditions. They were tweeting about it. They was having them in LA and Atlanta and stuff. So season 4 is coming. I tried to get a little inside information, you guys. I was trying to give it to you, but my little inside track is not allowed to say anything. So I can't tell you when Sunday's Best season 4 comes on. All I can tell you is that when it comes on, yes, I will be doing reviews, okay? I love Sunday's Best, so whenever. Okay, guys, I want to talk about Matthew Knowles real quick. We know a couple weeks ago, Beyonce's people and Matthew's people released a statement that she's no longer going to be managed by Matthew Knowles, and everybody was like, oh, Beyonce did it, boo, whatever, Beyonce, bye, go. Okay, do what you need to do, girl. I'm trying to come to the defense of Matthew Knowles, so I went to his website. There is still this huge picture of Beyonce on the website, and I'm just like, wow, really? I wonder if he's gonna take that picture down. I don't know. You know, Beyonce, with her career, that's a great credit to his company and what he's doing over there with the Music World Group record label and his management team. So, with Beyonce gone, I'm still a little iffy and a little weary of Matthew Knowles. I just hope that he puts 100 into these gospel acts, because he is snatching up people left and right. Right now, let's actually read off a couple of names. Vanessa Bell is one of the artists that is just now recently signed to him. He's also got Micah Stampley, Trinity 5-7, which he's had from the beginning, Brian Courtney Wilson, Juanita Bynum, and I think he's still going after some other gospel heavy hitters, trying to get them to sign with his label, or at least trying to manage their careers. They were all recently down in ATL this past Tuesday, I believe, and they did some big worship experience concert thingy. And I mean, people were talking about Music World Group being there, and that they were just taking over the building like they were part of Suge Knight's clan or something like that. They just rolled up into the gospel scene and did his thing. Matthew is putting his people to work. That's what I like. And I just hope that these people's careers can be just as successful as Beyonce's was, okay? Because, or at least Kelly and Michelle. At least, that's just how I feel about that. All right, let's keep it moving, people. Shirley Murdoch. You guys know Shirley Murdoch. When we lay tonight, okay, I can't sing, but you know, as we lay, you know her song. Anyway, she's doing gospel now, okay, or at least I think she's doing gospel. But anyway, she's gonna be doing a live recording coming up here soon. The recording is called The Journey. I'm not sure when the album will come out for this recording, but you know, she's gonna have Kelly Price, Regina Bell, and Beverly Crawford on there, so I'm thinking that it's gospel. I've heard that Shirley has gone gospel. That's what I've heard, okay. So, shout outs to Shirley Murdoch. If you're around, and I'm not sure where she's doing this recording yet, I forgot to write that down. But anyway, go to gospelflavor.com and look it up. It's on their website. James Fortune and Fire had some really surprising news to me. They're starting their own record label. Their record label, don't get it confused with Matthew Knowles, but theirs is Fire World Music. Matthew Knowles is Music World Group, okay? Fire World Music. I kind of thought this was kind of premature for them to be doing. You know, I don't know how James Fortune's and their album sales are, but they kind of remind me of how Rihanna's career does. Rihanna don't really sell albums, but they got singles for days, and their singles go number one. So that's how James Fortune is, and I'm just kind of like, really? You're gonna start your own record label? It wasn't but just a few years ago you guys just got into the game, but much, you know, they're still under Light Music. Light Music is gonna or Light Records, whichever one it is. All these record label names, they all sound the same. They're still underneath them. They're gonna help them out. Okay, real quick, so let's jump on over to a genre of music that I really like, Christian rap. Sho Baraka is leaving Reach Records. I don't even know what to say. Now, Sho Baraka, I just started liking him. He's leaving Reach Records. It's only been 4 years. I don't know if he's going to another label. I don't know if he's making his own label. I don't really know the reason why he's leaving. He said something on his website that was just in pure Sho Baraka fashion and form. To me, I hate to say this because I do like him. Sho Baraka is kind of a bit of a narcissist in my opinion. Like you know, he's those types of, he's like that person who, they're just very confident in themselves that they come off as arrogant sometimes. Sho, if you see this, I hate to say that, but that's just sometimes how I feel, you know, with his tweets and with the stuff that he talks about in his albums. I just kind of, not his albums, but the stuff that he talks about, like on his blogs and whatnot, and the way that he communicates. It's over my head. I'm not gonna lie. I'm sorry. I'm just not as educated as Show is. And so if you can't talk to me on a basic level and help me to understand some things, and you trying to be all worldly and educated and cultured, I can't deal with you. You know, I could do a little bit, but it's just when you go over my head, that's just where you're gonna stay. I'm not even trying to come up to where you are. I'm sorry. That's just how I am. Also in the Christian rap section, Ambassador and The Truth. You guys know that a couple years ago they had some infidelities within their marriages, but all is well. Everything has been forgiven. They're in this season of rebirth and restoration. So they have both left Cross Movement Records. They left. And both of them got signed to Exist Music. Okay. So both of them will be dropping albums soon. Ambassador's going to drop his, I think, in July. And Truth is going to drop his in September. We just have to wait and see. I'm excited for them because I like both Ambassador and The Truth. And I was upset, you know, when they did what they did and left Cross Movement Records. But it's all good, you know what I'm saying? So if you haven't heard any of Ambassador or The Truth stuff or Show Baraka stuff, guys, get on YouTube, get on Facebook, Twitter, whatever, iTunes. Look them up. There's some really good quality Christian rap music. A lot of Christian rap people don't like because they say, oh, it's whack and the beats suck and all this stuff. Not true for Ambassador. They got some stuff. Alright, let's keep it going, you guys. I'm almost finished here. There is another movie that I want to tell you guys about. You know, first I told you about Blessed and Cursed with Dietrich Haddon. I still have not seen that yet. I know. I'm going to buy it. I really am. I keep forgetting because you have to buy it online. And I just want to go to the stores and pick it up. But anyway, there's another movie that came out last month, I guess, towards the end of last month. And it is called Dreams, okay? And this has a slew of people in it. Angie Stone, Jeffrey Owens, you know, he played Elvin on The Cosby Show. Lou Myers, who played Mr. Gaines on Different World. Tommy Ford from Martin. Terry J. Vaughn, you guys seen her on Meet the Browns, Steve Harvey Show. Mel Jackson, who was in Soul Food and a whole other stuff. And then a whole bunch of other people. There's Vicky Wine is in it. Jay's in it. Jay's son is in it. That little basketball boy, Jalen Fleming from Chicago, he's in the movie. This looks like it's going to be a pretty good movie, okay? It's called Dreams. Check the closet door. I'm going to leave a link on there for you guys to go and view the trailer. Support these movies. I'm not calling this one a Christian film because I don't really think it's a Christian film. I just think it's a good film. I think it's just a good film done by people who are Christians. You know, they just happen to be Christians. So you guys check it out. Dream the movie. Check the closet door. Like I said, click the
just like music.
Hey guys, last but not least, we're gonna end this segment of Gospel Steward Reviews with some albums that'll be coming out that you need to keep your ears out for, so you can pick them up at your local stores or buy them on iTunes, whatever, wherever you get your music, okay? But the month of March was a really good month for gospel music. May is going to be the same way. But before we get into May, let's talk about some albums that have already come out in April and some that you need to be looking forward to. Twinkie Clark released her album with Humility on April 5th. Young Joshua released, he's a new artist off of Cross Movement Records. Young Joshua released Live Out Loud as well on that same day. Be on the lookout for Ricky Dillard and New G's live recording of Keep Living on the 26th of April, as well as Martha Minnizzi is coming back with her album entitled Make It Loud. I think that one's a studio album, but there may be some live tracks on there too, okay? So, guys, pick up those albums if you like those things. Also, let's talk about May now real quick. In the month of May, starting May 3rd, Yolanda Adams is coming with a new titled album called Becoming. I think that's what it's called. That'll be on May 3rd. Kim Burrell is going to release the Love album. It was said that she was going to release it on May 3rd, but now it's pushed back to May 17th. I think there's some contract disputes about what label is going to release the album that it'll come underneath. You know, is it going to be this new label that she's on, or are they going to release it underneath the old label that released her last album? We don't know. We have to see. Hopefully May 17th you guys get that. You can actually preview some of the tracks on her website, which is Backstage with Kim. She's changed it from the video that I was talking about last time, y'all know, the Kimberell video, she's changed it. It looks a whole lot better. It's actually, the album cover is pink and she's sitting on the word love and she just looks fierce. Love it. Kim, you do your thing. You've earned my respect. That's how I feel. You've earned my respect. Donald Lawrence, that's my boo. That's my Twitter boo. He don't know that, but I'm just letting it be known. Finally, May 3rd, he's going to release Your Righteous Mind. I'm excited to hear that just because he's been tweeting about who's in the studio with him and the production that he's doing. I love that, okay? Tadashi from Reach Records is finally going to release his album, The Black Light. It's going to be at the end of the month on the 31st, as well as Trinity 5-7, which I do have to do a recant. I had the right name, but the wrong face. You know, when I said that Adrian Anderson left the group, Adrian did leave. I thought that Adrian was the tall, black, dark-skinned girl in the group who I think is the Beyonce of the group. She's still there. Okay, so her name is Chanel. She has not left. Chanel and Angel going as a duo, releasing this next album. I'm not sure what it's titled. I think it's just going to be titled Chanel and Angel, but that's going to be coming out at the end of the month in May. Let's get that. They already have a single out now, but with PJ Morton. It's called Over and Over Again. I didn't like it at first, only because I like Trinity 5-7. They're kind of like another Mary Mary, in my opinion, where they're young, they're hip, so I like their upbeat mid-tempo stuff, but their ballads are really good. And I have grown to like Over and Over. I just purchased it off of iTunes, so you guys go purchase the single. Be looking for the album. That is the end. Okay, guys, so that is it for this edition of Stew Reviews, the Gospel Edition. Make sure you guys leave your comments below. Let me know what you think. If you know some things that are going on in the gospel community, make sure you also leave those comments and links below. I thank you guys for watching. Make sure you thumbs up this video. Follow me on Facebook and Twitter. Post this video on Facebook and Twitter. I'll see you guys around. Thank you for watching. I love you. God loves you. And Jesus can save.